The seventh question is identify the soil with the help of the following features. Now three features are given. One is red to brown in color, sandy in texture and saline in nature, and lacks humus and moisture. So through these three clues you have to tell this is which type of soil. So anyway, because it is saline and humus in lacks humus, so it's very clear that it is arid soil. So the correct answer is arid soil. So this is taken from the first chapter of geography, and the answer is given in page number 10 of your geography textbook, resource and development, type of soil. Now question number 8 is again taken from geography lesson number 4, that is agriculture. The question is a type of millet rich in iron, calcium and other micronutrients and roughage is. So the correct answer is ragi, and this is also given in your textbook in page number 38 of geography chapter. Now question number 9 is taken from first chapter of political science, that is power sharing. The question is population of Sri Lankan Tamils is concentrated in dash region of Sri Lanka. So this answer is given in page number 3 of your textbook, and the answer is north and east. So population of Sri Lankan Tamils is concentrated in north and east region of Sri Lanka. So children, you understand the importance of these paragraphs, because as just now we said, the type of soil, any feature can be asked. So you have to learn about the type of soil. Then we have studied about rice, wheat and all major crops. So features of these major crops also you have to remember. Then many of the glossary words which are given in your textbooks are also of immense importance. So this can also be asked. So this is the next question, that is question number 10. This is asked from the glossary, political science, first chapter. First question is define majoritarianism. So this is given in your page number 3 of your political science textbook, first chapter. So define majoritarianism. So this is from glossary, and the answer is a belief that the majority community should be able to rule a country in whichever way it wants by disregarding the wishes and needs of the minority. So here in this chapter we studied that Sri Lanka ruled in with majoritarianism. One more term is given in the same chapter, that is ethnicity. That means ethnic is the word which is given in your textbook, and the answer for define ethnicity is a social division based on shared culture, or people belonging to same ethnic group believes in their common descent. So this answer is also given in your glossary. 11th question is taken from political science, second chapter, federalism. And the question is which administrative authority legislates on residuary subjects. So in this chapter federalism we have studied about union list, state list, concurrent list and residuary subjects. So in union list the central government make laws, in state list it's the state government which make laws, in concurrent list we have studied that both central government and state government makes rule, but if there is any problem in that one, then the rule made by the central government will be ultimate or final. And the last one is the residuary subjects. So residuary, who makes laws on the residuary subjects? This is the question. So the answer is it's the union government or the central government that makes laws on residuary subjects. This is given in page number 16. Then second question is which administrative authority legislates on union list? So that is very clear from the name itself. You can write union government or central government. In some questions they have given internal choices. That means from the same chapter two questions are given and you can attempt any one of them. So in this chapter, that is political science, the second chapter federalism, they have given one internal choice. Then just now we studied in political science first chapter also they have given one internal choice. So this is all about politics. Now next question is from economics. So economics chapter 1, that is development. So if you remember, in page number 9 there is a table given, and in that table equitable distribution of income is given and some questions were asked. So similar type of table is given and it is asked that read the given data and find out which country has most equitable distribution of income. Now if you go through country A, so there is lot of difference between the income distribution. Like citizen 1 is getting 10,500, citizen 2 is getting 11,200, third citizen is getting 10,800. So it varies between 10,000 and 11,000, but no two citizen gets the same amount of money. In country B, if you check, there are four citizens who are getting 600 rupees and one citizen is getting 5,000. That means there is a lot of difference between the income distribution. Some are getting very low and some are getting very high. While in country A, there is no much difference. It is ranges between 10,000 and 11,000. In country C also, there is great difference. Like one smallest is 400 and the highest is 10,500. So there is a lot of difference between income distribution. Similarly, in country D also, there is a huge distribution. There is a huge range of difference. Like 700, some people get 700 rupees only and some people are getting 5,000 rupees. So you have to find out of this, which country is having most equitable distribution of income, almost same type of income. So the correct answer is A. A is having almost same type of distribution, because all of them are getting either 10,000 or 11,000. So rest, in all the three countries there is lot of variation. So A is the correct answer. Then in question number 13, read the information given below and select the correct option. This is from economics lesson number 3, money and credit. And this is given in page number 47 of the chapter. The question is, Mohan is an agricultural laborer. There are several months in a year when he has no work and needs credit to meet his daily expenses. He depends upon his employer, the landowner, for credit, who charges an interest rate of 5% per month. Mohan repays the money by working physically for the landowner on his farmland. Now you have to tell, over the year, his debt will increase or remain constant or reduce or be totally repaid. So now we have to look into some factors. See, his debt will increase if he is not doing anything productive on his farmland. It will remain constant if he is working for the employer but he is repaying less. His debt will reduce as amount equivalent to his salary is being counted as monthly repayment, and it will be totally repaid as he is repaying the debt in the form of physical labor. Now, since it is already written that there are several months in a year when he has no work, that means he is seasonally unemployed. So in that case, it is very difficult that he will be able to pay back the loan. So out of these four options, increase the debt will be the correct answer, because he will not be able to pay back the debt and it will keep on increasing, because if he don't has his own agricultural field, he is working in somebody's field, so he cannot expect to his condition to become better, so his debt will increase. So first one is the correct answer. Now from the same chapter, one more question is asked, that most of the agricultural laborers like Mohan depend upon loans for informal sector, from informal sector. Which one of the following statements about this sector is correct? Now the four statements given, out of that, which is more suited for informal sector, that you have to find out. For that you should know what is formal and what is informal sector. So we have already studied that taking loan from money lenders, relatives, friends, traders, landowners, these are the informal sector of credits. So if we take loan from the informal sector of credit, which one is correct out of that? First, there are government bodies to supervise informal sector. Of course, this is wrong answer, because there is no body to supervise the informal sector. Money lenders ask for a reasonable rate of interest. That is also wrong. Money lenders always charge more rate of interest. Cost of informal source loans to the borrower is quite high. Yes, it is the correct answer, because when he takes loan from the informal sector, he has to pay back a lot of money, so his cost of borrowing becomes higher. And the last one is money lenders use fair means to get their money back. That is also wrong. They use unfair means to get their money back. And this is answer is clearly given in page number 49 of your textbook. Economics, chapter 3, Money and Credit.